Okay. It definitely doesn't hurt him. It helps him, I think.
Have you come up with a main event for that UFC on Fox 3 card, or is it going to
be? Not yet, no.
So it's not doing yet?
No.
Do you know how many tickets that sold at Chicago? It sold out, yeah. We're 15,000. And what's the impression of selling the arena in Sweden? I'm excited. I love when we go into these new markets like this and we sell out so fast. Let me tell you what. Sweden is going to be awesome. That fight's going to be crazy. I'm so excited for it. The thing that sucks is I'm filming The Ultimate Fighter live on Friday and have to fly out at like 10 o'clock at night to try to get to Sweden on time for the flight. So that's the only thing that's bumming me out. I'm going to be in Sweden for about 5 hours.
Hey, Danny. The Ultimate Fighter Brazil. Sure.
Yeah. I fly to Brazil next week to start filming The Ultimate Fighter Brazil. We're expecting it to be huge. You know, we've got the numbers that we're pulling down in Brazil on free television are like NFL numbers here. And
like 40 million people.
Huh?
40 million people.
It'll be crazy. Yeah, we're really looking forward to it. I fly down there next week. The first day of filming is in Rio, and then the next 2 days are in Sao Paulo.
Are you bringing expectations from this card? Is it you guys just simply want to do better than the last one?
We'll see what happens, man. We'll see what happens.
Dana, I know you don't, root for any particular fighter, but how big do you think a fight between Rashad Evans and John Jones in Atlanta would be?
Big. I think it's a huge fight. I think that Chael Sonnen or Michael Bisping versus Anderson Silva is huge too.
It seems like most people are treating the Bisping Sonnen fight as the main event. You know, there's more attention paid to those guys. And does that, what does that say about Rashad and Phil?
Nothing. I think that people love. I think they love to see the guys fight that they hate. You know, so many people hate Chael and so many people hate Bisping. It's like all of, when I'm watching Twitter, it's like, Jesus, I don't know who to root for. And then you got other guys going, now I'm a Bisping fan when I wasn't before. Now I'm a Chael fan.
Yeah.
You know, so I think that's what makes that fight so
when
fun.
When you think about it, you have Rashad, Bisping, and Chael, three of the four most hated guys on the show. And I was thinking, didn't Joe Silva fail by not putting Koscheck on the card?
Yeah.
And you would have had a full house.
It's true. Would have been the most hated card ever.
And with the way that both Chael and Michael can talk, is there regret that there wasn't more of a time for them to build this up other than just the 10 days?
Nah. You know, it is what it is. I think, to be honest with you, these guys really haven't talked as much as they normally do about each other.
Right.
I think this is one of those fights where these guys both respect each other. Now, let's be honest here. Bisping is probably, other than Koscheck, the most hated guy in the UFC. You got to give the award to Koscheck. But Bisping being a 5-1 underdog, that's crazy. That's nuts. I mean, the guy fought Rashad Evans. The guy fought Hamill. You know, he's fought a lot of really good wrestlers. The kid can wrestle. And he's got good stand-up. And he's good on the ground, too. He's got good submissions. He is in no way, shape, or form a 5-1 dog. Just goes to show how much he is disliked.
You think Koscheck is more hated than Rashad?
I do.
Really?
Dude, there's some people I've seen cheer for Rashad. I've never seen one guy clapping in an entire arena when Josh Koscheck walks out. Ever.
Speaking of international
work,
Floyd Mayweather is overseas trying to expand.
Well, we're going to be in Japan this year, Sweden. We're real close to doing a TV show in India right now. Real close to India and what's the other one? That's it. I think that's it.
Is Macau in the picture, Dana?
Sydney, Australia.
Oh yeah, we're going to Australia. We've been there before.
It's going to be Ultimate.
Yeah, that's what I was about to say, but that wasn't the question you asked me. We're real close to the Ultimate Fighter. The Ultimate Fighter, Australia will be kicking off there sometime, and India.
Are the two Ultimate Fighters going to be like one after another, as far as like the one that's with Dominic Cruz and Faber, the next Tough Brazil? Or are they going to have
Tough Brazil starts filming next week?
Okay.
They fly to Brazil next week to start filming.
So that's going
to
be the following season to the Dominic Cruz and Faber season.
What?
Is the Brazil Ultimate Fighter, is that going to be the following season after the Dominic Cruz and Faber season?
Next week we start filming Brazil.
They're running concurrently.
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh, airing. Yes. I'm sorry, I misunderstood. Okay. They will air at the same time.
Okay.
Yes.
Dana, in the past, you guys at the UFC have always stayed out of the drug testing stuff. but you guys had the new policy announced recently. We've seen some positive stereotypes. What was the reason for the change in policy?
Yeah, the way that we figured this thing is, let's get the guys coming in. It's worked with the Ultimate Fighter. When you come into the Ultimate Fighter, first of all, you get a full background test, check. You get tested for, you know, steroids and every other kind of drug and everything. And it's been a very good policy for us. You know, there's been a lot of things that we found out medically about guys coming into the Ultimate Fighter that was very positive. So it makes sense now. If you sign a deal with the UFC, you got to go through the full drug testing, and hopefully we won't have to go. Listen, guys testing positive for stuff is bad for us. It's not good for us, it's not good for them, it's not good for anybody. And one of the things that we really, here's the problem. When you get these young guys, and we know how, you know, steroids and all these other things work that these athletes are doing, when you get these young guys, you're 21, 22 years old, whatever it is, and you start taking this crap, your testosterone level drops and your body stops producing it. So what it does is, if you're a talented guy that could be in this business for a long time and make a career out of this, once you get off that stuff, because you can't do it here, you're going to get caught, right? Once you get off it, you're ruined for life, mentally, physically, emotionally. You always, that's where this testosterone replacement therapy is coming from now. These guys who abuse this stuff younger and, you know, earlier in their life now have to do this stuff because their body cannot produce testosterone. So if we can stop that stuff early with these athletes that are young and have the talent to be here, you know, we feel like, you know, we'll win half the battle.
Is Chael still doing that now for the TRT?
I have no idea. I have no clue.
Could you see expanding the program to, you know, test some of the guys who have already signed with the UFC?
What do you mean?
Random
testing.
Dude, that's the commission. We're the most regulated sport on earth.
Mark Brander said you would actually try and push for it.
We're the most regulated sport on earth.
But what about
we're the last guys on this fucking planet that should be getting steroid questions. Guys are gonna pop. If you went in and tested the way that we test at the NFL, Major League Baseball, and everywhere else, there'd be no sports. We wouldn't be watching shit on TV.
What about the complaints that, you know, guys learn how to cycle off because they have enough notice?
What are you gonna do? Seriously, you have 375 guys. Do you guys know I'm a shit I deal with on a daily fucking basis that has nothing to do with steroids? You know what I mean? I mean, let's be honest. I know that's a fun thing for you guys to talk about, but it's ridiculous.
Why do you think the percentage is so high that guys are caught in California? It seems to me that if you're getting a huge percentage in California, a lesser percentage in Nevada, that there must be something wrong with the testing.
Who knows?
Right? I mean, because you would have to think the same percentage of guys are doing it everywhere.
Yeah.
They're not just doing it more in California than it.
Actually, never thought about that. I have no idea.
But California's way higher.
Are you concerned that the testosterone replacement therapy kind of gives guys a second chance? Because like you said, you know, some of the guys who use it are the ones who used to be using steroids.
Well, what happens is when you go into a doctor and they tell you that your testosterone is low, what happens is you're supposed to gauge. They take the blood test and they gauge where you're supposed to be for your age. What a normal man his age should be at. And that's what they go by. I mean, what you have to understand is, listen, I'm no doctor or expert. You know, this is just what I know from learning about this stuff, is that these guys have to do it. When you have no testosterone because you've destroyed yourself from using steroids, you're basically dead. I mean, you have no energy, you can't do anything. So this testosterone replacement therapy thing is real. And what they try to do is they try to find the guys who are abusing it. Because, you know, if you go in and I don't know, 1 cc gets you back to where you should be, where will 3 cc's put me? And that's, you know, that's how they got in this mess in the first place. So that's what the athletic commissions watch for, is guys who are, you know, they come in the week before the fight. The other thing that's been good is guys who have abused it and have gotten caught for it, everywhere we go, these guys are now being tested, you know? You saw the stuff that went on with Overeem, and the list goes on and on. There's more than just Overeem. Now lots of guys, when we go into these different states, guys that have been popped before, now have to do this random testing. It happens, so.
Are you hopeful that by doing this new procedure, that a guy like Mo Lewis, who recently tested positive, and not tested positive before, and saying that he didn't know some of the stuff that was going in the system, was that, but I'm just saying that now, do you think that that'll help prevent that type of stuff in case guys?
One of the things that I don't like, listen, if you get caught doing something, admit you did it, okay? The whole somebody put something in my system that I didn't know about, I mean, who here lets people put shit inside of you if you don't know what it is? I mean, if you go to the doctor and he gives you a pill, like, doc, what am I taking this for? Well, this is gonna, you got an earache and this is gonna help, you know? I don't buy that shit. Own up to what you did. Listen, it's out there, it happens, and sometimes everybody makes mistakes. The problem is, what we wanna do is, we wanna put this policy in place where we, the up and coming guys, we're already talented. You're already talented. You're already fast. You're already strong. You already have all the attributes to be a professional athlete. Do not ruin your career by taking this jump that will affect you for the rest of your life. So we're trying to get these guys early. And once this thing is in place and guys know it's going to happen, hopefully they won't do it.
So what you're saying, what you just said, obviously you're not buying this guy not taking it.
I don't buy any guy. But I'm just saying, I don't buy anybody.
Any guy, anybody
that's ever said when a person that they didn't know what was being put in their body is full of shit.
And when they say that, what does that say about their future in you in Zufa?
I don't know. It depends on how they handle themselves. I don't know. We'll see. But anybody who gets caught for taking any kind of drug and says, huh? I didn't know there was some drug in me. You know what I mean? If you're taking pills, or, you know, the whole theory of I was taking these supplements, and there was a time, like, I don't know, 6 years ago or 7 years ago, where guys were getting popped for steroids, and they were these over-the-counter supplements that they were taking that were this close to being actual steroids.
Will John Jones be fighting in Atlanta?
I hope so.
When will you know for sure?
I don't know. I'll tell you when we do. Yeah.
Has the UFC ever considered having an outdoor match?
A what?
Outdoor match.
I hate it. I hate it with a passion. But yeah, this Brazil one might be. Adam. Yeah, we might. I guess what happens is when you're dealing, like, let's say we do a soccer stadium down in Brazil, and it rains. You know, the fans down there are used to watching soccer matches in the rain, so they're kind of used to that. We are not used to that. We'll see what happens. I don't even like having press conferences outside. You know, I don't like doing the weigh-ins outside. I don't like going outside.
Well, Dana, what if Aram is supposedly building that stadium on the Strip, right? That's going to be a 40,000 seat. And
Bob's going to build it?
Well, he's got Sheldon Adelson and Wynn building it, but that, you know, and they're saying it's going to last for 2 years. Theoretically, if that's built, Vegas hardly ever rains. I mean, wouldn't it be a good place for you to do 40,000 as opposed to?
See, here's the thing about Vegas too. I used to go to the fights at Caesars when I had that outdoor thing,
right?
And it was cool sometimes, but Vegas gets so windy. Like, you can wake up in the morning, it could be the nicest day out, and by 5 o'clock, the wind's blowing 100 miles an hour.
Right.
So that kind of worries me. I just don't like. You guys know the show that we put on inside an arena. The energy and the buzz and the only place we've ever even come close to doing that outside was Abu Dhabi.
What's